Hello everyone, I am Dr. A. Kaviyarasi from Department of Physics, Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Chennai. Today, we are going to see a topic, acoustic grating. Generally, the sound waves are classified into three categories based on their frequencies. The sound waves of frequency less than 20 Hz are known as infrasonic sound, which are inaudible to human ear. The audible range of frequency starts from 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz and we human can easily hear this sound. The ultrasonic sounds of frequency are about 20,000 Hz. This is also inaudible to human ear. Even though the ultrasonic sounds are inaudible to human ear, it has a lot of engineering and medical applications. Today particularly, we are going to see such an application with the help of acoustic grating. So let's see what is acoustic grating. The main principle behind this generation of acoustic grating is when ultrasonic waves are passed through a liquid, the density of the liquid varies from layer to layer due to the rarefaction and compression of the liquid, that is due to the variation in pressure. And hence the liquid will act like a diffraction grating when it is illuminated with a monochromatic light in a direction perpendicular to the propagation direction of ultrasonic waves. Hence this is called acoustic grating. So here, let's see how this acoustic grating is formed in a liquid medium. So let us consider a rectangular tank of water. Here, the RF oscillator and piezoelectric crystal is forming a piezoelectric oscillator which will generate ultrasonic wave. The generated ultrasonic wave is allowed to propagate through this liquid medium in such a direction like this. So the propagating ultrasonic wave will be reflected by the opposite wall. So the wave will be reflected back and propagating again in the opposite direction like this. So this forward direct ray, initial forwarded wave, and this wave reflected by this wall will be forming a standing wave pattern. Those will superimpose each other and forming a standing wave. So over the standing wave, the node portion is having a greater density of liquid due to rarefaction, and the antinode portion is having a lesser density of liquid due to compression. So here the alternative nodes and antinodes will be there, that way it is having a opaque and transparent. Node portion will act like an opaque region where the density is more, and transparent region is nothing but the antinode portion where the density is less. So when this standing wave over this liquid cell is illuminated with a monochromatic light in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of ultrasonic waves, this liquid cell will act like a diffraction grating. So hence this is called acoustic grating. So when it is illuminated with this monochromatic light, the diffraction pattern will be observed over the detector or the screen. So that's why this is called acoustic grating. Now let's see how its functioning style is similar to that of conventional diffraction grating. The reason is here this acoustic grating is full and full analogous to conventional diffraction grating. Let's see the similarities. Here the right side, this is conventional optical grating. So it has more number of rulings in it, micro rulings. These rulings are made and these rulings will not be visible through our naked eye. When it is focused through a powerful microscope, the rulings will be observed. So normally in gratings over a glass plate, nearly about 15,000 lines per inches or 20,000 lines per inches are made for the laboratory purposes. And when this kind of grating, that is optical conventional grating, is illuminated with the white light, when it is allowed to pass through that, the ruled portion will act like a transparent region that will allow the light to pass through that, and the spacing between the two ruling is called opaque, that won't allow the light to pass through that. So thereby the interference, that is the diffraction pattern, will be formed over the screen like this. Now come to this acoustic grating. As similar to that of conventional grating, here this node part where the density of the liquid is greater will act like opaque, and antinode part where the density of the liquid is less will act like a transparent region. So that is why when this propagation path of ultrasonic wave was illuminated by a monochromatic light source in a direction at right angle to the propagation direction of the ultrasonic wave, a diffraction pattern will be observed over the screen. So that is why the acoustic grating performance is analogous to conventional diffraction grating. Then what is the use of this acoustic grating? So with the help of this acoustic grating, one can do the modulation of light used in the optical fiber communication, and this is also used to find the wavelength and velocity of ultrasonic waves in the liquid medium. So now we can see how this wavelength and velocity of the ultrasonic waves are determined with the help of experimental setup. So this is the experimental setup to calculate or to determine the wavelength and velocity of ultrasonic waves. By knowing one factor, other can be easily determined. So this is a water, that is a liquid cell where this ultrasonic waves are generated with the help of this piezoelectric oscillator. So when this liquid cell is illuminated with a monochromatic source of light, so when this light from this source will be allowed to strike over this liquid cell in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of ultrasonic waves, as we know, the node part won't allow the light to propagate, antinode part will act like a transparent region. Through that way, the light will be transmitted, thereby forming a diffraction pattern over the screen. And here this setup is nothing but this is a combination of spectrometer and a liquid cell, and therefore the diffraction pattern is observed over the telescope of the spectroscope. So once found this resultant diffraction pattern over the telescope, and after getting the result, we can easily calculate the wavelength and velocity. So let us take lambda L, the wavelength of the monochromatic light source, and lambda S, the wavelength of the ultrasonic waves in the liquid medium. Then the grating element, that is nothing but the sum of width of transparent and opaque region, that is the width of node plus antinode. That is, if A is the width of a node and B is the width of antinode, then A plus B is called a grating element. That is equal to wavelength of the ultrasonic wave, that is lambda S. This lambda S is equal to 1 by capital N. This capital N is nothing but number of lines per meter, that is maybe a number of transparent region or number of opaque region per meter is N. So now with the help of that, using the standard grating formula for getting diffraction pattern is called Bragg's law, that is sine theta, that is equal to N into M into lambda. Here in this equation, theta will be replaced by theta M. Normally theta is angle of diffraction, here it corresponds to angle of diffraction for the mth order, and this N, capital N, is number of lines per meter, that may be opaque line or a transparent line, and M is order of the diffraction, that is order maybe 1 or 2 and so on, and lambda L is wavelength of the monochromatic light. So since we know that N, number of lines per meter, is equal to 1 by lambda S, wavelength of ultrasonic waves, so we can substitute this in this equation for diffraction. We will be getting that is lambda S into sine theta M is equal to M into lambda L. So from this we can easily calculate the expression for wavelength of ultrasonic wave as lambda S is equal to M into lambda L by sine theta M. And once you know the wavelength of ultrasonic waves, once calculated lambda S, by knowing its frequency, if nu will be the frequency of the ultrasonic wave, then we can easily determine velocity by relating the frequency and the wavelength of ultrasonic waves. Therefore, V, the velocity of ultrasonic wave, is equal to nu into lambda S. Nu is the frequency of the ultrasonic wave and the lambda S is the wavelength of ultrasonic waves. Hence, this relation will give you the velocity of the ultrasonic wave in the liquid medium. So hence, this acoustic grating is used to determine the wavelength and velocity of ultrasonic waves in the liquid medium. So this application of acoustic grating. So that's all about acoustic grating, and thanks for watching. Thank you.